and non-market economies. Well, as I've said, that our negotiations in this area with the Soviets are just beginning. Commerce Secretary Peterson returned yesterday for 2 weeks, mostly in Moscow, but also in Warsaw, during which time very considerable progress was made. We're narrowing our differences, which have kept us from settling our lend-lease debt for 25 years. And the good faith which the Soviets would demonstrate by settling the debt would set the stage for a presidential order permitting Ex-Im Bank credits for sales to the Soviets. And it would also open the way for a presidential request of the Congress
facility tested its low proximity magnetic distortion system for the third time. Details regarding the results of the experimentation have not yet been released.
During a press conference held in April of 1988, Ivan Beck, Vice Director of the ASIN Foundation, described the intention of these tests, stating this program, if granted sufficient backing from the United States government, will offer a solution to all current and future storage and residential needs, and save billions of dollars on property construction and management.
I'm Ted Koppel. There has been a rather strong earthquake in Northern California, so strong, in fact, that it has, among other things, knocked out all the power, or much of the power, at Candlestick Park, where the third game of the World Series was being played. But in the overall scheme of things, that may be the very least of things that has happened today. You can see some video there. I gather that's live video of Candlestick Park.
And we are feeling a shock right now, and that shaking in your picture is being amplified by the tremor that has just gone through the top of the stadium, and we are live. They're taking the bases off, 8:41 Eastern, 5:41, and we just felt it out here. We're at ground level.
This is a live shot from our affiliate, our owned and operated station in San Francisco, KGO, and you can see that there are at least two major fires that seem to be in progress there. Let me just explain to you that what we're doing here is we are listening in on the broadcast of our affiliate in San Francisco, KGO, because a great deal of the information that is coming is more readily accessible to them than it is to us, and they have reporters reporting live from around the entire Bay Area region.
Whatever they can to stop the fire, but part of the problem, obviously, is gas.
Store water, prepare for aftershocks, prepare for 3 days of no services. You got 90 minutes of light left. You better make use of your time. Standing here ain't doing nothing.
We have Leslie Brinkley standing by live right now. Leslie, go ahead.
It's looking bad over here in Oakland. The electricity is out in much of the city, and we have a bad freeway collapse. It's that ramp of the Nimitz Freeway that goes from Cypress Street on up to the Bay Bridge, about a 6 or 7 block stretch of it, collapsed during the earthquake. They are pulling bodies out from underneath this lower ramp. There were just some injuries on the upper ramp, but those on the lower ramp, there are a lot of fatalities.
The epicenter of this earthquake is about 100 miles to the south in the Santa Cruz Mountains along the San Andreas Fault. We have had very difficult time getting any information out of that area tonight. Now our own Tony Russomano is live in Santa Cruz now to give us some notion of what's happened. This is our first report from there. Tony?
Pete, this town of 40,000 is about 10 miles from the epicenter of the earthquake. You would expect the damage to be severe here, and it is. The downtown section of Santa Cruz is basically gone. All the old brick, unreinforced buildings have collapsed. This is a department store called Ford's. It collapsed. The second story came down into the first floor, trapping several people inside. At least three people are known to have died here on the mall, perhaps 12 to 14 total in Santa Cruz. Authorities do not have a final fatality figure. Many, many other people are injured. Power has been out for several hours.
Have a decent heating system down here, that'd be nice. Die of hypothermia.
Oh, hello, camera. Police just dropped you in the bin right there. Make sure to get the red one, right? Because, yeah, the green one reads.
Come for. There's no insulation on top, and I'm seeing a bunch on the floor above. There's ventilation as well. You see that? You see the vents?
Yeah, it goes around the block to the right.
Some of it's insulated, I think. I don't know, I'm not a vent guy, I don't know. Oh, it looks, no rust, I think. Huh.
It's more than one floor, and I use that term loosely. We then attempted to cut power to the nearest fluorescent light fixture, a standard troffer. However, we were unable to isolate the power source and the conduit remained live, despite the absence of any visible external power supply. The source of electrical current remains unknown at this time. Using an insulated toolkit, we carefully isolated the light fixture from its electrical conduit, extracted the troffer from the ceiling, and transported it back inside, back to standard for analysis. And they added a 0.5 meter sample of conduit was also taken with all exposed wiring safely secured afterwards in the ceiling. So the ceiling tile extracted measures 1.27 meters by 1.14 meters, which is certainly not standard, but it's composed primarily of mineral fiber. It seems normal in composition, has a fissured texture with mild tegular edges. So after initial analysis, the composition of the tile estimated is around 60% mineral wool, which is fibers of amorphous silicate, usually derived from, I think it's basalt or swag, around 20% expanded perlite, which is primarily of silicon dioxide and aluminium oxide, and the rest is a unfined mixture of silicate material, some starch, latex polymers, and some organic fibers derived from plant materials. Recycled cellulose, really. But the light troffer housing is made of galvanized steel coated with a thin layer of zinc. Inside, the fluorescent bulbs are non-standard in proportion, most closely resembling T12 bulbs. So the four bulbs measure 1.2 meters in length with a diameter of 38.1 millimeters. We're extrapolating here, only 51, but that all the end wafers and the rest contain the following components. Phosphor coating, the calcium hemophosphate for converting ultraviolet light to visible light. Mercury vapor in a small quantity, which facilitates the ultraviolet light emission. Argon gas, and again, this is all standard for these fluorescent bulbs, but that's an inert gas that assists with the with regulating the current and really starting the bulbs, and they are connected via a G13 base, which is a standard two-pin base with 13 millimeter spacing for electrical connection. So the wiring connected to the fixture is PVC insulated copper, which appears standard again. The prismatic diffuser over the bulbs is made of polymethyl methacrylate, which is, again, commonly used for its light diffusion properties. I mean, it's what we have in the building here, very standard. But we also inspected the ballast, which is of the electromagnetic type. There's some variation in how they're being manufactured now. This one contains a laminated steel core and copper windings designed to operate at 60 hertz. So the ballast emits a prominent 120 hertz hum. This seems to be the case for the majority, if not all, of the lights in the complex that we've assessed thus far, mostly just through simple curing. But this is due to magnetostriction and core vibration. But the noise may be exacerbated by loose lamination plates or degradation of the insulating potting material over time. So it's definitely an indication that this has been running for a little bit. I mean, despite its age, the ballast is functional. Its large proportion suggests it was built for a non-standard space, not something you'd find in the majority of offices or most commercial spaces, though that's something that's not something I'm too familiar with, truthfully. Now, we did find, so material compositions all seem expected, or we know, we didn't know what to expect here. They seem everything we've looked at so far, again, this is rudimentary early testing, but everything seems pretty congruent with what you might expect from one of the troffer lights you could pull out of the ceiling in this building right here. So nothing too strange, but it's maybe that maybe makes things seem stranger. Because we look at these lights, and So several labels were marked on various components of the troffer. So on the ballast, we found markings for marked as a universal ballast, type A, manufactured in 1975 with serial number A75234X. The troffer itself is stamped 3X432, and that was manufactured in 1973 in Reading, Pennsylvania, and it is UL listed. And the bulbs were manufactured by Sylvania, and they marked F40SW, that's soft white, with no visible date information. It's left blank, but it is noted as made in the USA. So, I mean, though outdated in design, the fixture appears fully functional. The stable operation of all light fixtures in the subdivision points to a continuous, potentially autonomous power source, which still remains unidentified. We're doing what we can. The materials used are durable with minimal visible wear, suggesting they were built for long-term, possibly indefinite use. So this concludes the initial findings. Further investigation is necessary to determine the source of power sustainment.
Subject is male, somewhere between 18 and 21 years old. I estimate that the time of death was around 5 days ago, but due to the severe tissue damage, it's hard to say for sure. The cause of death was likely malnutrition. I was able to recover most of the digestive tract. So, things start to deviate from what we we would consider to be natural, the decomposition process appears to have been stunted somehow. It's like portions of the body stopped decaying and were sustained. Other areas, however, were completely overtaken by culture. So I took a couple samples of some of the material here. First, I thought it was an aggregated collection of Pseudomonas fluorescens, but it seems to be closer to a mutated strain of simple hay bacillus, which it should be completely benign, but, well, really, I don't know what to make of this. Mr. Beck, may I ask where this subject came from?
Research and development team. In this short informative video, you will be briefed on the required protocol in regard to Project KV-31, as well as receive an overview of future development plans. What is Project KV-31? Project KV-31 pertains to the study and development of the async low proximity magnetic distortion system. For the sake of convenience, you may hear your peers refer to the project under any of the following titles: The Machine, The Door, The Back Rooms, The Complex, Hallways. Unauthorized usage of these terms outside of the Async Research Facility is strictly prohibited. Touch the threshold without guided supervision. Never enter the complex alone. All expeditions are to be comprised of no fewer than 3 individuals.
Yeah, but that was 2 weeks ago. I'm not going to be doing anything about it now. I mean, do you really think that there's actually a vaccine in this situation? I mean, there's too many variables, because probably they've reset the whole circuit, and it's doable. So we don't know how it is, because I want some hand to turn to my eyes, and I have a movement for...
I'm going north. Guys, can you hear this? Hey guys, can you hear this? Hey! Guys. guys. Get moving! Fuck. Hey!
Thank you. Thank you. the vertical expansion been approved yet?
They're not getting to that until after the presentation.
When does that go through?
Sorry, can you repeat?
What day will the tour be over?
From the 7th to the 10th.
Next report out?
Yeah, should be good.
Alright, end of the day tomorrow, I think? Got the cable? Okay.
Falls off pretty quick. Might be at an angle.
And we've got a door?
Don't recognize the design.
You need to cover all the way over there. Assembling a locker would be redundant. Well, we know it's just another dead end.
Alright, I'll take a look. Go notify Cloud.
Everything okay?
Marvin, get the camera over here.
Across?
You're fine, just hurry.
Okay. Sure, yeah. Okay, just, one moment, alright?
Okay. Okay.
Quick, seriously.
Yeah, I'm going. Walking on normal ground. Even there.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm alright.
Oh, thank Christ. Are you injured?
I think I pulled something in my shoulder. I'm a bit dizzy, but no, I'm fine.
Describe your surroundings.
It's different. Like a room up there, but the architecture's the same, but the wallpaper is different. It's a bit greener. Hold on, I need to see if... Nope.
Yeah.
I'm not reaching the tunnel I fell from. The opening comes out through the wall, but it's too high.
Okay, just stand by and stay put for a moment.
Got it.
Is the camera intact?
Seems to be fine. I'm recording, but who knows what the output will be like.
Mark, make your way back over to this side. Carefully.
Do we have another camera? I need to get this. It has to wait. This takes precedence.
throw down the guideline with the weight attached. I can use it to climb up.
Just tried that. There won't be enough length to reach you. George, go run back to standing and bring a tether. Hang in there, Marv.
What was that?
What was what?
I don't know.
I didn't hear anything up here.
Sounded like... I think there's somebody down here.
What?
You're yelling. Like, a person is yelling.
Wait, a person?
Yeah.
That makes no sense. Are you sure you're not just hearing us?
No, it's definitely not from you. Left hallway, and it's right there, under the gap in the wall.
You need to stay at the hole. George will be back any minute, then we can assess the situation from there.
Shh. But what if Miller's right about the null zones?
Even if that's the case, I agree with Mark. It's not worth the risk.
Oh my god.
Marvin? Marvin, do you copy?
Hello?
Hello?
Can you hear me?
Marv, what are you doing?
I'm trying to find them. I know how to get back. It's fine.
Keep us posted.
Can you hear me?
Anything?
I'm answering one of the hearts. Where the guy is coming from.
Okay. This is odd.
There are inverted turn signs in this room coming out of the carpet.
They're inverted? What do you mean by that?
Mirrored. They're not oriented properly. I think I'm losing you. Just stand by.
Repeat, Marvin, do you copy?
This is Marv.
Okay. Good, we read you.
I think someone's been living down here.
Living down there? That's not possible.
Hey! Can you hear me?
I think I found him.
Sorry, can you repeat that? Marvin?
That's not a person.
What is that?
That is not a fucking person!
What? Marvin, talk to me. What do you see?
Send it down!
What is that?
world around us is ever-changing. Throughout this past century, we have seen the advent of countless innovations that have completely reshaped life as we know it. But with all of this growth comes a number of undesirable byproducts. Byproducts that, if left unchecked, have the potential to irreversibly scar our modern world. As human expansion is projected to increase exponentially in the coming decades, we must account for these never-before-faced challenges in ways equally never-before-considered. Here at Async, we believe we have found the solution. The Low Proximity Magnetic Distortion System. What is the Low Proximity Magnetic Distortion System? Using 32 will be distributed across all points, allowing for cargo and personnel to seamlessly pass through their designated threshold. While our current threshold is limited in scale, future models will be able to span entire rooms, allowing for the transfer of larger vessels and equipment.
So,
glad you think that way. As a matter of fact, if you look to laws for the page, you see critical technologies in the world by failure to recognize that by having a system of declassification of certain elements, having the industry be with us at that point. Sorry, I'm over here. Sir, please take a look at this. If you could all just excuse me for a moment. My apologies.
Research Institute in San Jose, California. I'm trying to get hold of my supervisor, who I believe is currently staying at your venue. Ivan Beck? Yes, that'd be great, thank you. Clyde. Hey, it's me. Do you have a second? Fair point. So I've got a bit of a problem going on over here. About 45 minutes ago, I was called back down to KB31 because apparently, while the Department of Energy was reviewing our contract, an employee managed to set off the complex motion sensors. Actually, they went perfectly. We've got all the initial signatures, and the contract should be executed by next week. I'm glad to hear it. Back to the problem though. So I get called down to figure out why we have a fully suited employee in the complex after hours on an off day. But I have no idea who this is. He's definitely not on the project. Well, I tried to talk to him, but he's completely disoriented. He doesn't seem to know where he is or who I am. Yeah. He said his name was Peter Tench. Ivan? Probably over the cameras. I'm the last one here. Everyone else is headed home. No, just me. Wait, hold on. This isn't him, is it? Thank you.
enough room to unpack over there.
Okay, sounds good.
Can you loosen that strap?
Say three at the very least. It'll take seven trips that way, I think.
You
should have forklifts on you, yeah.
Watch your hands.
Yeah, we're just assembling now.
Stop up here and just a few to the right. Carry on forward and head into that gap over on the left. Stop.
Yeah, it was blocking.
Standard, this is Clyde. We've reached room 14D. We're now just about to initiate the equilibrium steering steps.
That's still good.
The last one came back good, but I recommend you keep a mask on just to be safe.
We gotta start updating our protection system. I feel like I'm always missing things in this mask. Yeah, maybe we'll just conserve some power. Let me kick it back in the cart when we get here.
Hey team, this is Mark. Do you copy? Copy, reach 11th. We have just reached 14D. There are no visible signs of Marvin's friend.
That is absolutely not the name we're going with.
Well, then you better start working on a new one. This one isn't a better deal. You know it means. Remember that? These ones are all fairly even, right? You just have to go on that one.
You just focus on going down center and around those two points of interest. I believe the car sheets will suffice for today.
Alright, well, that's good to hear. Are you ready to start sending people down? I know we don't have that many hours left before we need to start revamping the material protocols. We need to double check again on 1, 2, 5, 7, 3 as well. Hey, can I get a hand over here?
Is this the same one they had you practice with?
Pretty similar, but they were just renting that one. Same one as far as I'm concerned, though. Not like I know the difference.
Wouldn't want to be on the other end of that.
You wouldn't want to be on the other end of any gun margin.
Yeah, that's probably true.
Alright, get your lights on. Marv, light.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Standard, this is Mark. We're now beginning our progression into room 14C. Alright, so we're gonna want to stay mostly down the middle, but maybe go around one or two just to make sure we're not missing anything.
You're damn playing this mouse.
I don't know. Okay, yeah, floor's different. Looks like concrete, what was it called? The stuff they layer over concrete to make it shiny.
Epoxy?
Yeah, epoxy. It looks like we got standard white drywall with black vinyl trim or wall base. Ceiling looks relatively the same, just tighter, smaller tiles.
It looks like there's another space between the floor types.
Oh yeah. I guess we can put a tape measure down there again. We got displaced tiles. Yeah. See anything?
No, not really.
Well, there's a little hole in the back.
Oh yeah.
Is there a wall back there? A wall? Or can't tell what that is.
Well, it just looks like a wall.
Watch the gun. Sorry.
Is this just the natural state, or there's something new to these? I'm not sure which one I'd prefer, but right now I'm kind of leaning towards the former.
Yeah. I believe we've only seen displaced tiles, four? I think it was four times before. Not too common.
Guys,
I found something.
Yeah?
You get a look at this. What, is it right over there? Yeah, it's some sort of... No, you're right, this looks handmade. You can't determine that just by looking at it. No, I'm just assuming right now. Either way, you're right, it does look like some kind of map.
Yeah. You know, it almost looks like...
I think this is around here, 14C.
Yeah, it's,
Team A, come in. This is Mark.
That's the area we came through. That's 14C, and there's 14B.
Team A, this is Mark. Do you copy?
There's B and A.
Standard, do you copy? Repeat, this is Mark. Do you copy? No, the signal's dead. We've gone too far. We gotta go back.
What? You sure? We're not that far.
Well, that's all the more reason to get...
Well, if we do get back and they say it's just a non-issue, we just come back around and around and see what the-
Oh my god!
He's got my gun! He's got my gun! He's got my gun!
Don't move! Never you move!
Okay!
I don't want to hurt anything. But I will. If I have to, so please, just... just answer my questions and I'll be gone. How many people are out here right now? Down the hall, how many people are out here?
I don't know.
Peter?
Oh shit.
Marv? Marvin?
Yes, it's me. Is it really you?
It's me.
How? It's been months, we thought you...
I know, that's what they did. They took my life from me, Marv. Everyone thinks I'm fucking dead. My wife and children think I'm dead.
Can you please put down the gun?
Barbara, just tell me. Did they hold a funeral?
Yes.
This is Team A. Do you read us?
Yes, A-Team. This is Mark. I read you.
Mark, don't.
What are you doing?
We need immediate RPG no. Room 14C. Stop. My team and I are being held at gunpoint by a hostile. I repeat,
stop. Don't shoot him.
Stop.
You don't.
Sorry.
Don't.
Authentic order of events as we understand them. On the morning of March 1st, a team of four researchers was sent into the complex to conduct their routine layout analysis. George Levy, Marvin Lee, Ronald McCarthy, and Peter Tench. At around 12:25 p.m., the group realized that they had lost track of Tench while traversing a previously accessed branch of hallways. As you'll recall, this prompted an immediate withdrawal of response back to standard, followed by several days of significant search efforts. However, those ultimately yielded nothing, and as far as any of us were concerned, Tench had simply vanished, leaving no physical trace. Now, for obvious reasons, that wasn't something that we could disclose to the public, so roughly 2 weeks following his disappearance, our security team was forced to put together a more acceptable cause of death that would keep attention away from this institute and provide closure to the family. So, that is all close to common knowledge, I presume. Not all of you were with us at the time of the incident, however, you're certainly aware of the effects it has had on our internal procedures over the past few months. Regardless, that was where Tench's involvement in this came to an end. Or, at least, that's what we assumed. Because on May 8th, at approximately 5:30 p.m., a motion alert was sent out from the complex, which was closed off at the time. One of our senior engineers was sent down to assess the situation, and discovered a male dressed in hazard gear who we were able to identify as Peter Tench. Immediately following this discovery, Tench was moved to a secure room on this floor, where over the following days, a select group of doctors were able to administer a panel of tests in order to determine what had happened to Peter in the 2 months he had been gone. Those tests yielded very little useful information. By all measures, Peter appeared to be in excellent health. However, we were still provided one very useful tool in understanding how the situation unfolded from his perspective. Some of you may recall that on the day of his disappearance, Tench was his team's designated camera operator. Well, when we recovered him, he still had that camera in his possession, and in fact had documented the entire ordeal. The footage will be presented in its entirety later today. However, for the purpose of this discussion, I will only be highlighting key events. This is the hallway where Peter was last seen. They're not in view, but you can hear the others walking behind him. Now, as he approaches the branch on the right here, pay close attention to the audio.
Guys, can you hear this?
Waiting our goodbye. We did our best to keep him engaged, but it is it's hard to combat the effects of prolonged sensory deprivation on the human brain, and as a result, Peter's mental state took a toll. Not to a degree that was outright concerning at first, but around the end of week two, we noticed that he was starting to exhibit a number of behaviors common in patients diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia, though we don't have reason to believe that Mr. Tench was afflicted with that condition. Whatever the case, while he didn't express it outright, from what we could gather, he appeared to have deluded himself into believing that he was still inside some sort of illusion created by the complex, and that we were secretly looking to do him harm. This all came to a head on the night of the 22nd, when, while Tench was finally about to be transferred to a temporary above-ground residence, he broke away from us and, using stolen credentials, forced his way back into the complex where he would go undiscovered until just last night, when he ambushed and violently attacked Team B in room 14C, leaving Dr. Bloom in critical condition. We can presume that during the two or so days Tench spent in the complex, he let go of the idea that he could somehow escape through an alternate threshold, but still held on to the belief that all of us here were working to trap him in some way, despite our actions saying exactly the opposite. Immediately after firing a single shot from the Remington 870 to Dr. Bloom's side, Tench fled the scene and headed to the threshold outpost, where he would turn the weapon on several more of you while progressing into standard and through the lower offices. Given the abrupt and chaotic nature of the unfolding situation, it took our security team several moments longer than it ideally should have to figure out what was happening. But thankfully, while Tench was passing through one of the empty labs next to storage, Dr. Maxwell was able to act quickly and managed to disarm him, accidentally discharging the weapon into the ceiling in the process, though. However, Tench still managed to avoid apprehension, fleeing into the maintenance wing and evading our security staff by taking the freight elevator to the surface. Now, this situation could have played out very badly, given the potential number of witnesses around the building at the time. But luckily for everyone involved, as far as we can tell, Tench was not noticed as he exited the property. Around 5 minutes later, our security team made it to the ground floor and began a thorough sweep in the direction of the hillside where cameras had last observed Tench. Now, there's no easy way to say this other than to just say it. I am terribly sorry to inform you all, but Mr. Tench was found deceased halfway down the hillside. The result of an extreme blow to the head. It appears that while he was running through some brush, he failed to anticipate a sudden dip in the ground and tragically fell forward into a large rock. Given the circumstances, it was not something any of us could have anticipated or prevented. The tragedy of the entire situation undoubtedly remains, but Dr. Tench, regardless of how troubled he was in his final days, was a brilliant man who gave his all to this project. He would certainly not want us hindering it in his name. What we're doing here is so much bigger than any one person. It is the work of a unified effort, and we need to ensure that that is never lost sight of. That we hold on to the pre-established notion that Peter is and has been deceased. That is done, and there is nothing more to be extracted.
Sound? Camera?
Rolling.
All right, and action. All right, cut. Cut. That was good. That was good, guys. All right, that was good. I'm thinking we get a wide angle, and then we're done.
Okay? All right? Yeah, cool.
Like, how much further? Like?
A little more. Right. A little more.
That?
Yeah.
Whoa! Hello? Hello? Hey guys. What is this? Hello? Is someone there? Can anybody hear me? Hello? God damn it. What the hell? What the hell? Don't move.
This isn't real. This isn't real.
I saw you chasing Bert's ambulance.
Hutz is the name, Mr. Simpson. Lionel Hutz, attorney at law. Here's my card. It turns into a sponge when you put it in water.
Ooh, classy.
I'd like to talk to you about bringing legal action against the fiend who did this to your boy.
Well, the fiend who did this to my boy is my boss, and besides, the doctor says it's just a bump on the head and a broken toe, nothing serious.
Doctors. Doctors are idiots. There's no telling what kind of permanent injuries he might have. You might have to wait on him hand and foot for the rest of his natural life. That's the downside. Now, here's the good part. You can ching, 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 cash in.
Macol constituye acción, ayuda a aliviar la tos, la congestión y a expulsar las flemas. Y la consulta de sabor sabe tratar la tos.
You're right, you're right. When you feel up to it, come over to my office and we'll talk about it. Lionel Hutz, attorney at law. What's that, a broken neck?
Ray!
Hello, Dr. Hibbert.
Hello, Lisa. Well, we've got a nasty bump on our head.
Okay, so you may be wondering what I'm doing. Recording a square of tape in my garage. I swear I've not gone crazy. There's a very good reason for this, and if you just give me a moment here, you can see for yourself. Okay, I don't think it's worth trying to explain what's gonna happen here. You just have to see it to believe it. So I've got some wood chips here, just a bunch of wood. And I just watch this and prepare yourself because it's really freaky. Watch the square. Look at that, gone, they're gone. All right, I'm gonna show it again just because wood chips was a little bit of a weird example, but here's a baseball. All right, and just watch. Gone! It went into the floor. All right, I'm going to do a couple tests now. I've got this tape measure here, and I'm just going to let that down and see how far it goes. I feel it's like vibrating. Hello? I need help! Hello? It's just a couch. What is this place even for? Hello? Oh. Okay, that's all hole on the floor. Hello? Is there anybody in there? Okay, there's gotta be a staircase, right? Elevator or something? How do people get in here? Okay. Who the fuck built this place? What? Anybody here? I'll go that way. None of this makes sense. Hello? What is that? Better still be recording. Hello? Is there someone in here? Hello? Do you need help? Okay, what the hell? What is this? Is it like plant?
Oh, In the Oklahoma City bar.
Back to the hotel that night and was listening to the footage, I realized I recorded a Monsanto exec joking with a DPR manager about this sick kid referring to it as the bug-eyed one. And sure, I like making fun of diseased kids as much as the next guy, but right after that, one of them basically admitted to fault, which, mind you, they aren't doing publicly at all. They said something along the lines of, well, hey, if we accidentally push out the entire county, you might just get that ranch you always wanted. Fucking A, man.
Sorry, I think I'm gonna have to call.
This is Robbie. I'm a tenant in the upstairs of Fairmont. Yeah, that's me. I'm just calling to ask to see if there's anybody supposed to be checking out the downstairs today. Okay, so no, like, maintenance or anything?
Hey! Someone there? Hey, someone here? Hey. Someone there?
Even here. Even meant for. This is in the. I don't see where this could be above ground.
I'm trying to leave. I don't want any trouble.
Check, radio check. Does anyone copy? Radio check, radio check. Do you copy? Testing. 1, 2, 3. Hello, hello. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Hello, hello. Does anybody copy?
Hello?
Someone out there?
I'm sorry. I don't know where I am. I need help.
You're on private property. You need to leave.
I'm trying, okay? I don't want
to
be...
This is the guy who keeps coming around here trying to talk to my boys.
What? No. My name is Ravi, sir. I'm not trying to cause you any trouble. I'm just lost.
My family's trying to sleep. Leave or I'm calling the police. If you really need help, the station's a quarter mile down the road.
Listen, I can't. I've been walking for like 9 fucking hours, man. Where the hell are we? I can't even see you. Actually, do call the cops. That's fine. Just please help me out here. Hello?
Where are you?
Well, what?
Where the hell are you? I just looked outside and I don't see you.
I'm not... I'm in like... a living room with a... fish on the wall.
What is this? Is it some kind of game you're doing? Are you having a laugh over this?
I'm not! It's just, it sounds like you're on the other side of this wall, but this door goes nowhere.
Are you in my walls?
What? I don't know where I am. I've been trapped in this goddamn hell building for hours, and you're the first actual person I've found, so can you please just, I don't know, get a hole in the-
I don't understand. How is this possible? I can hear you, but...
I don't know, man. I don't know. I just need to go home.
Why can't you leave?
I just told you there's no fucking exits or anything. This place keeps going on forever. Can you just show me where the exit is, and I'll be out of here.
Okay, alright, listen, we're having some of the wainscoting here redone. I can open up the wall here, it's still loose, but I need you to move slowly, alright?
Thank you! So
come out with your hands first, I want to see your face, and we'll take things from there.
Thank you. I think it's...
What the fuck? What the fuck? What? Oh my god. Hey, my god! What the fuck? What the fuck?
Hello? Hey, what happened? Hello?
It's been a while.
I'm thinking I'm running out of time to talk to a lawyer about my, job. I keep thinking about this moment when I was seven. It was at that park back home when the windmill thing with the face used to scare me. The summer, the sky was, I don't remember the sky. It was hot out. Gary and Linda were there. You were there. I think you just got that large bike that got stolen. A lot of your friends were there. I can see your faces so clearly. I just want to go home. Sorry for all the stuff that I didn't say. Just gonna fix it.